What's going on, everybody? K-Cam here, and in today's video, I have a Coach K-Cam, and I know that might sound like a copy off of Coach Merck's series back that he did back in Black Ops 2, and I apologize for that, but I mean, Coach K-Cam kind of sounds pretty cool to me, and I thought kind of the K sound going along with Coach and K-Cam, like that's three right there, I think that sounded pretty cool and that went along well, so I decided to kind of just name it that. And carry on Merck's legacy, I guess. I don't know. But anyways, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be giving you guys some tips on Breach Hardpoint right now. And I might as well just kind of like go down every single map, start with the hard points, go through the uplinks, CTFs, and then S&Ds. And so basically, what I'm going to be start off by talking about is you need to make sure that you guys coordinate your tacticals. You don't, I mean, I guess you could try stuff like four stuns, stuff like that. But personally, I only like to pull out EMPs if they have streaks. So I'll just make sure that I have a class, but I also make sure that I don't run them unless we need them. And so what you want is you want at least one person with trophies, preferably either single or double, unless they don't nade. If they don't nade, there's obviously no point in trophies. And so, yeah. But another person should be running stuns. One or two people should be running stuns. And heck, you could even have three people run stuns. But normally it's going to be a mix between stuns and trophies. So make sure you guys coordinate that. And then also you could coordinate nades into that as well. Because I know some classes only allow you to have like one. Like if you have, for example, a fast hands and you have tac mask, it means you have two perk threes. You can only put one nade or flash. Or one nade or tactical. So kind of coordinate what everyone has. Because if you all run the same thing, then you're not covering a broad variety of situations, I guess. So anyways, that's just kind of the prerequisite right there that I'd like to talk about. Off break, if you have this side, normally it's best to get an AR, top AC. And then what we like to do, we just kind of flood the other two out here, which is normally John and Huntsman. Huntsman normally runs to hill. John normally runs to ramp. And what I like to do is I like to hit this bottom wall run because most teams never expect this. Sometimes they will, and that kind of costs us a couple seconds at the beginning. But a lot of times they never expect this, so I can just like come up right here, and I have a perfect position. So as long as John keeps ramp, and then Logic's normally going to be sitting up here with his AR. As long as he covers that, he can sort of watch over that, and then John has that side. And Logic just sort of has to be aware of his back right here because they can push around and go all the way up his AC steps right here and shoot him in the back, and they can take spawns just like that for the next hill. Then we got a pretty good setup because I got this side. Huntsman just has to hide in hill, and if he wants to, he could even watch wall run from here. And another thing that you could technically do, but it wouldn't really be too helpful, you could slide your AR down here and watch this. But the reason I say it wouldn't be too helpful is because then they could just like start kind of flooding out from here, and that lets them get closer to the hill. And another thing that I'd like to do is just kind of set them up right here. And like kind of set John up right here. And if you set John up right here, he can just watch this and then kind of peek up every once in a while. Watch that. And then if you go back here, you have Logic sitting right here. He can then either drop down here, watch it from this side, or he can even go out a door, and he's holding our spawns, and then we're going to spawn right back there. And actually, normally, we're going to spawn right here. So if he's holding this right here, they can't flank around from Palace, because John's watching that, and they can't flank around from Porta-Potties, because Logic's watching that, and they can't push Huntsman and Hill, because I'm watching that. And then all Huntsman has to do is just sit down in Hill, just stay down, normally right here, and he's fine. So that's basically how that's set up. Now, of course, they could wall run, but I'm going to doubt that most teams are going to do that. Most teams are going to normally challenge you head-on right here if you're sitting ramp. And if you do notice that one gets wall run, I wouldn't recommend pushing Palace, sort of like just running into it, because that could force your spawn all the way over here into Palace. Unless, I mean, I guess if that guy's over there, your spawn still should be good, so you could sort of get away with right here, but then he doesn't have as much help over here. So like if I get flooded, John would take forever. I couldn't speak right there. then John would have to take forever to come all the way from Palace through here and then kind of help out Huntsman. And at that point, when he gets there, they're already going to be flooding Huntsman. They have Hill, and then John's going to be there with an AR by himself. So that's not the preferred position. And then if you go over to this side, I just use Heat Wave right there. Lol. But if you go over to this side and you have this spawn, we're not necessarily as good in this side, but you do get a better spawn for the hill. So if you wanna just rush straight to hill, you can. And you can sort of just like get the early pick right here because you will beat them to it. And what we like to do is I like to just jump over here. Look, Palace. If I win the gunfight, that's big. And we should get more time off that as long as we can have the other people stay alive. Now, normally, John would go top broken. And I think Logic, I'm not sure what he does. I'm not sure if he goes top box or what. But normally, top box is going to be a power position. So, top box, Palace, and Hill, and somewhere on this side. And then you can try and rotate your setup to get over onto the other side, the power side. So, really, no good spawns that you want on this hill. But you do want to make sure that at the end of the hill, no matter what, you want these spawns. So, one common thing that most average hardpoint teams do is they don't flood spawns. They don't worry about spawns. They just worry about hill. They worry about pinching hill and getting all the angles in hill. Well, that's a problem that SSK had for a long time too. We never flooded spawns, so we'd always have one person just try and come back here and challenge them, and sometimes we'd get him, sometimes we wouldn't. And then if we did, he'd get flooded and we'd lose spawns just like that, and we'd lose hill. So you have to make sure you're flooding spawns. And for this hill, the spawns that you want to have someone sitting right here. And as long as you're holding this side, you should spawn right here. And I mean, you could spawn out if someone else pushes out. They're obviously not going to spawn you right in front of someone. But if you have someone right here and there's only one of their teammates here, they're still going to spawn you relatively close. Obviously, they're not going to spawn you back here, but they're going to spawn you relatively close. But the bad spawns for this hill is if you give them up and you let them slay you out right here, you will spawn all the way over at green. If you have no control of this side of the map, you will spawn all the way at green, and challenging it head on this way is not going to be the best way because then that means you have to go through porta potties, through a person that's over here on the side. Then you also have to get into hill, kill that guy or those guys that are in it, and then you have to flood the spawns from there. And so it's obviously much harder because you have to go through much more people just to get spawns. And then if anyone dies, they're going to spawn way back out and they're not going to be able to help. Whereas if you flood spawns and then someone dies, they're going to be able just to help right away. So I basically just explained how to break it and how to hold it. Actually, hold up. I didn't explain how to hold it. But basically, you just break it by flooding spawns, and then you can just kind of take it however. And the hill will just normally come with spawns, so just worry about spawns, and hill will come. So, a good setup would have one person here in the back, kind of just watching this side, occasionally peeking out into there. You have an SMG in hill. You have an AR right here, kind of watching this side. Or if you can push up porta potties, which is what I like to do. I like to set someone up here. While we have an SMG in hill, SMG right here, AR by the door right here, just kind of, he can look mid and wall run and stuff. And then you have the person in the back just holding spawns. So that's my personal favorite setup. But one thing that I do notice is that a lot of teams like to set spawn or anchor, a door, hill, and sometimes they'll set two hill. They might set one, they might set two on this side, a door, just kind of look in front. They can set one right here a lot of times. But my personal favorite, I love pushing someone up to porta potties because if you don't, I'm going to give you this little map view. So you see here, right at porta potties, I don't know if you guys, just as long as you can read a mini map, you're good. Actually, you know what? I'll be friendly. I'll let, instead of making you guys do stuff on your own, if you have someone porta potties, that gives you control of this area all the way to back there. If you don't have control of porta pot, or if you don't have someone porta potties, then it's basically a duel, so to speak. So like you're gonna have to win gunfights just to keep control of it. Whereas if you're porta potties, you can get a pick, possibly a two piece, possibly a three piece, and they're just all gonna keep flooding you, and you're just gonna keep getting easy kills just like that. And so I love having some porta potties just because it gives you more control and it keeps them further away from the hill, because as soon as they push past porta potties, they can get a kill while someone's reloading right here. And then they can just easily start flooding front, flood the hill, and then you're stuck in a rough situation because you have the person back spawns. They should be spawning up back there still, but you're still kind of in a crappy situation because you're going to be getting pinched from there, and you're going to have to challenge hill as well because you don't want to give them too much time. So that's that. Going to the next hill, the spawns you want, you can spawn really for the majority of the hill. You can spawn either side, but one thing that you have to make sure is you have to have someone pushed up on this side. Now, one spot I like to use, I like to either lay down like right here, just kind of wait for someone to push, or some I like to kind of sit right on this because I can hear wall run, I can see them coming in through here, and I can easily shoot them in the back rather than right here where I could catch them off guard, but I still have to win a gunfight or two. And so I like having, normally it's myself that pushes up that side, and then you're gonna want someone in control of mid. I like to push someone out mid. You can see what type of player I am. I like to push stuff out so we have control of it rather than just counting on gunfights to keep control of it. Just having a person there to kind of block that. And then you have, normally John sits back here. He just kind of sits green tarp, watches flank, and just kind of keeps this side pushed out because you can literally spawn. There's a spawn for this hill that's literally right here. And if you spawn right here, it's pretty easy. And you can just, it's literally like 3 seconds to get back into hill, and that's that. So that's my favorite setup. Another setup is just kind of sit two people in hill, so like just kind of use take advantage of all the corners. Normally they're just trade spots where you'll get one and then get traded, but it's still pretty useful if you just set up like a couple people in different corners, and then you have one person push out that side, one person push out that side, and any other people in corners that can just kind of pick up wherever they need to, and they will most likely start coming in from ramp, and they won't know which corner. So if you have a crossfire going, you could even set up like a crossfire right here. You just got to be careful not to shoot your teammate. Then you have the other person here. You can set up a little bit of a crossfire, and yeah. So that's how I like to hold this hill. How I like to break this hill. Normally, it's just pushing as a team. You have to make sure in hardpoint that you push as a team. So if you're on this side, make sure you flood as a team. Like, basically play trades, make sure you're playing as a team. I like to go wall run around right to here, and I can normally get a gunfight right here. He wave him if I need to. And then normally they have a person playing this side trying to pick up my teammates that are here, and I can shoot them in the back. And that's normally an easy break every time, but we can't always get into that position. Sometimes we spawn them back here. And so we have to flood it from this side, and that's not too easy because they can sort of get the jump on you because there's a lot of spots you can sit to watch this side, whether it's in hill, computers, back here, just anywhere. And then you can even sit right here, and the only way they can kill you is wall run, so you can even watch wall run. So it's not easy to break from that side. And normally sending one ramp should do it or should help out a lot if you're spawning out. And not like back here. If you're spawning out, normally sending one ramp would help out a lot just because you can get those easy trades and possible two pieces, and it's not just gonna result in like a four piece for the other team. So that's how you hold and how you break that hill. This next hill, the spawns you're gonna wanna keep are right back here, and this is a terrible hill for us as a team. So, not necessarily like we don't know what, well, okay, we don't know what we're doing. I'll be that honest. My teammates, I kind of look at them on the minimap and I'm like, what are they doing? But I don't really want to call them out on it because I want to be a good teammate and stuff. But your anchor, you want him to sit right here with an AR. He only wants to watch this side. Now, the reason for that is you want an SMG pushed up here and just kind of looking this way so that he can get broken steps, he can get bottom broken, and he can just hold statue. Where that person just has to worry about that. Now, if he needs to, he can peek up, help out the anchor back here, and I get countless two pieces just coming back here to help John. And that's what you need to play, or that's what you need to do. You need to play team hardpoint. You need to play as a team. You need to get your help. You need to make sure you gotta have your teammates back. You gotta keep them alive, help them out. Because he is keeping your spawns, that anchor back there. He is keeping your spawns. He's a reason you're able to get back to the hill so quickly. You need to make sure that you can keep him alive by helping him out. And you really want to keep everybody alive. So, the more people alive, the better. And then, for the person sitting in the hill, it's normally Huntsman. You can sit up here, watch this side, because if we have the back controlled, he shouldn't be getting top. And as long as we have front control, he shouldn't be getting anywhere. And another spot he can sit is back here. I don't like this spot as much for the setup. Just because if he's right here, they can easily just start kind of coming in front and he's really screwed. There's nothing he can do besides win one-on-ones and hope that he gets a lucky two-piece. So my favorite spot's normally over here. Personally, I don't like going all the way up here just because it's so predictable. I kind of sit in right here. You have more cover if they push in, whereas if you're up here, you know, you can't really see anything. But then if you're on here, or if you're right here, half your body's covered when they peek it, when you're able to see them right here. And I like that a lot better. And then some people even like to play right here just because it's close. You can see them as soon as they come in. And, yeah. So, one mistake a lot of people do is they will push mid. So, when someone stats you, they will push mid. And I noticed Logic was doing this in a breach hardpoint earlier. He was mid. He ended up dying. And that just gave up the entire hill because they had front control. They just flooded Huntsman front. And John and I did all we could. We couldn't do anything. I think I got a two-piece on spawn, and I had one extremely weak in hill, but there was really nothing we could have done. So that death mid and just pushing mid really hurt us. Now, what you want to do is sometimes people will sit right here, just kind of watch in front, but then wall run, it's sort of a soft spot if they come wall run because they can just kind of push you, and you have to move all the way up and adjust. Make that adjustment with your analog stick. So what I like to do is top green, watch wall run every once in a while, peek out. You know, just keep watching this wall run, peek out. And if you do that, that prevents them from even getting to front. So you see more control. You have more control of the map, and you're keeping them further away from the hill. So a Huntsman could just chill in here, you know, just kind of do whatever he wants, dance a little bit. Because I have this whole entire area from here, from top broken, bottom broken, statue, and I got John's help right here. I can easily help him. John's got this whole area right here. He's got our spawns right here if anyone dies. And it's just super easy control. So that's how you hold the hill. That's your preferred setup. Now, if you spawn all the way out, the bad spawn's going to be right back here. And you're going to spawn way out. And probably the best thing to do would be to flood spawns if it's early on. But if it's not early on, then the best thing to do, I mean, I guess just make use of your stuns, your nades, and then just literally flood hill. They're probably going to have one top green, one in the back, and one somewhere statue broken somewhere. Mid, maybe, I don't know. But you just want to flood this. Use teamwork. Push this together. You can't just go in one-on-one. You can't just go one by one, die, and then really that's the end of a push. You just gave him 20 free seconds. That's not how you want to do it. You want to slide people in like crazy. Just bombard them in the hill. There's normally only going to be one to two people in hill. You kill them. You worry about this angle right here. You don't want to peek it too wide, really, because if you do, you could get killed easily. And then your teammates have to worry about a trade, and you just lost one body in hill. And that's less control. So when you break that, then you just kind of want to be cautious of this angle. And what you can do is just send a couple people top, wall run around the back, and you can easily kill their anchor. Just like that, you get spawns. Now, granted, if it is late in the rotation, like there's 25 seconds left, 30, basically less than, yeah, I'd say about 25 seconds left, you shouldn't worry about spawns too much. Now, obviously, spawns are still great to have. But with this hill, you don't want to worry about spawns too much with 25 seconds. Just because if you get those spawns, then you're spawning all the way out for this next hill. Since it goes cross-map, there's really just getting those spawns could hurt and give up a couple seconds in the beginning. And really, getting the rotation is normally going to be more important than the 15-20 seconds of scrap time. So, for this setup, this is a hill that we're great at. We normally set 1 AC. And then I'll sit right here, and most people don't even know about this spot. Like, last game we played, I think I killed two people as they came in. And they didn't even look my way. It's just such a good spot because people don't expect anyone to be over there since it's such a since it's basically like an irrelevant area because there's nothing over here. You can literally mantle these and they can't see you from mid because look, you can see just in the first person model that my whole body's behind it and my gun's up above the thing. And so they can't see a single part of me right now, and so I can just get easy kills. And then you also want, preferably an AR pushed out A door, and just kind of watching the side. Normally, cages would be alright as well, just because you can get some unfortunate gunfights right here. If they come AC and they have this whole cover right here, you can get a little unfortunate there. So you want to be careful about that. A lot of people like to go cages and just kind of hold it this way because that's easier. And they can peek out at room. And a lot of people also like to just kind of hold it from here. And again, you can get a little unfortunate with this little thing right here. But you know, it's whatever. And one thing that is super important, the spawns you want are back here. You can literally spawn right here for a hill that's right here. So make sure, normally, what we do is I like to have an SMG just kind of put, or just kind of like set up right here. So at any time they push, you can just easily slay him. And occasionally just kind of like peek out, make sure they're not there. And then he's there for the help if he needs to. So that's how I like to kind of set that up there. And I mentioned the person up top AC looking over mid, palace, whatever. If that person AC looks over palace, then you're in a really good shape because if he's watching palace and the only way he could get killed from is mid. And so as long as he's got palace locked down, you shouldn't have to worry too much about the spawns. And so really if you wanted to, you could set up with like kind of a non-default setup and just have a person watching palace and he's going to be super tough to kill and you can have a person set up AC just watching mid or even something that a lot of teams do which is really risky. You can have a person top box and that gives you all that extra control here in mid and that's normally going to spawn them out and that's going to force them to either go palace or green side and so it can buy you time as long as your person watching Palace and your person watching Green can get kills. It'll buy you a lot of time because you can easily get kills. It's so hard to kill people off of this head glitch here. It's insane. So, and then to break it, really your best bet's trying to just basically pinch it from all angles. Mainly the back's the best place to push from. Back A door, front's kind of the worst spot. Just because there's so many angles that you have to fight through. You have to fight through this angle, and this angle just to get to the person back. And then you have to worry about this angle. So there's a lot of angles here. Whereas if you go the back, you just have to kill a person there. And then you worry about sort of just like this angle, this angle, this angle. And then if you can push in a hill, just this angle. And then if you push A door, it's kind of hard because you have to worry about there could be a person sitting in a corner, which is super common for people to just sit right here in a corner like this, and just kind of watch over mid and the back here. And like if anyone pushes in, they can easily just kill them and just easily gun them down. So a lot of people do like to do that. So you have to be cautious of that. I normally just like jiggle peek it, shoulder peek, make sure there's no one there, and I can get in the hill. But then you have to worry about this angle, this angle. And this angle almost all at the same time because if you're right here, there's that. But if you watch front, I mean, if you sit in this corner, you just have to worry about front at first. But then you also have to worry about the people that are over there and there. So you have to make sure you're getting those key kills in the hill. And then you should have help arriving as well. So if this person focuses on you over there, which would be a very rookie mistake. Then this person, if you send one mid, can easily just get the pick right there. Or you could even send a person AC, kill a person AC, and then you have so much more control. You have this entire entrance to hill opened up, and you can start flooding it like that. And gives you oh my gosh, I cannot talk right now. But it gives you a lot better chance of breaking the hill. A much better chance. Alright, there we go. Finally got the English out of my mouth. But it gives you a much better chance of breaking the hill. And then, so yeah, basically to break this hill, just pinch it and play trades from all angles, sort of like Palace. And then, you know, just hold the hill as long as you can. And then next hill, again, As long as you're spawning on that side, if you get scrap for that, you can just set up in the default that I mentioned, that I talked about earlier. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Definitely had fun making it. I always have fun sharing my knowledge with people and just kind of making people better and influencing people. So, again, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Like, comment, subscribe. Comment if you have any comments, suggestions, questions, concerns, anything. Like the video if you want to see more. And also, comment if you want to see more as well, because I do have a lot of fun making tips videos and my analysis videos that I do on stream and videos like that. And I'm also going to have a live com, or not a live com, a listen-in going up, I think, today of a CTF. So make sure you guys are on the lookout for that. And it's definitely a good gameplay. So I hope you guys have a good day. Thank you guys for watching. Follow the links in the description. And I will see you guys later. Goodbye.